Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Nanny and the Moose. I'm Nanny. Do you think you are a super ager? Do you think you might want to be a super ager? What are super agers? It's that group of us that are up there in our 70s and 80s, even 60s, 70s, and 80s. Well, first of all, you might think they're those men and women who get up at 5 in the morning and put on their shorts and go down to the beach and run about 12 miles up and down the beach. That's not the kind of super agers that I'm talking about. It's not the 90-year-old marathoners that run and win the prize. It's not that either. It's normal people like you and I who have made up our minds that we are going to change our attitudes and perhaps live a happier life longer. And do you know that the 65 and above age group is now larger than the under 5-year-old age group in the United States? Might even be worldwide. I'm not sure about that, but definitely the United States. That's fascinating. So what does that tell us? That tells us that we're all living longer, mainly because of medicine, and also because of something else that's something you might not believe. It's not genetics, although genetics plays a part, but not the largest part. It's all about lifestyle, choices, and the changing behaviors that seniors are making. All of a sudden, you reach your 60s and you think, well, this is it. We are not having too much fun after this. Well, that's not true. Moose and I are almost 84, and we can attest to that. Now, you can have your issues. Yes, our bones break a little easier at this stage of the game if we're not careful. Yes, sometimes we can't forget somebody's name, but that's not a big problem. That's normal. As a matter of fact, there's something called crystallized memory. And believe it or not, many, many seniors, those of us up there in our 70s and 80s and above, have better crystallized memories, which are the knowledge and the judgment that we have of the past, of memories of long ago, of things that we've learned and applied to our life today. And we have better working crystallized memories than those that are 20 years younger. Are you beginning to get a little interested in this? Are you maybe gonna wanna be a super ager? Maybe you already are now. Now we're gonna talk about some habits of super agers, and that includes the normal ones that you might think. Eating behavior, exercise, keeping your brain going, that's a biggie, as you know. And socializing. Socializing is a really important one. As a matter of fact, research and surveys show that seniors who keep their lifelong friends and all their connections with family and stay active and socialize, live longer and happier, and are healthier too. Ah, these are getting interesting, aren't they? And the exercising, if you can't walk 1 or 2 miles a day around your neighborhood, stretching is great. And so far as myself, I do gardening and I do an awful lot of bending and stretching just in the normal things that I do in the course of a day. Sometimes if I really want to do something, I will walk up. We have a very long driveway that's a little hilly, and I will walk up and down that. Last year, I actually, when we were out and about, I used to go to the mall and kind of combine my entertainment of shopping with some good exercise. This one you're going to enjoy. Now, you can be a social butterfly, and that includes a little bit of what they call tipping the elbow. Believe it or not, that a glass or two of alcohol or wine a day is good for you. We've always kidded about the fact that it's good for the heart, but guess what? It is. And it also is good for your relaxation. Coping. That's a word a lot of people don't like. Oh, we're coping. That means you're just kind of putting up with something. Well, don't cope. Be above that. Now we're going to get into some of the fun facts and habits. What you can do if you're interested in being a super ager. I'm going to put my glasses on because I'm going to read some of these things from my research. Here's some of the habits of senior agers. They live a very active lifestyle. Now, that doesn't mean they walk 10 miles a day. And you can still have your disabilities, so to speak, and still be active. Many people, like Moose, who have some issues with balance, he does his exercises. He does what walking he can. And certainly his mind is way, way, way up there, above many, many people in their 70s and 80s. You continue to challenge yourself. Now, you have to deal with frustration, they say. If you're going to be one of those people and challenging, challenges of all kinds, getting a new hobby. What would you be challenged at? If you have never painted before, try some painting, see if that works. Sewing. Crafting, any challenge that you can do with your, get your mind going. They say that is a benefit because it gets your neurons and those other chemical things inside us going. Now, some of these other habits are, these super agers have decided that they can handle changing lifestyle behaviors. In fact, research shows that seniors are more adaptable than younger people in being able to adjust, as we have done during this pandemic. They can also handle emotional issues better than the 18 to 35-year-old group. So we have some things going for us already. So we might as well keep going down that path to super aging. I'm sure most of you probably have a dog or a cat or birds or whatever. Haven't you found that your pets are the most wonderful source of comfort and love? My cat, you wonder, what does a cat know? Honestly, that cat knows when I'm outside, I want to always call him she. All he wants to do is be near me. And if he's not sitting in my lap getting his comfort, he's right next to me. Just a little while ago, I was out checking the garden and good old Shamu was kind of following me around. Pets are wonderful. And a cat is a little easier than a dog. Dog does have to be walked, or perhaps you have a doggy door and the dog can go in and out on his own. But if you are alone, and I'm sure you know this, pets can be wonderful for comfort, but do get out there. I read something really funny. A doctor was giving advice to a senior, and the senior was overweight, not obese, just overweight. And we all worry about calories and keeping our weight down, especially when we're older, a good diet. And the doctor said, it's okay. No, he said, it's not bad to be skinny when you're young, but it's very bad to be skinny when you're old. Do you know my doctor told me that about 8 months ago when I hopped on the scale? That was longer than that. It was before the pandemic. And I got on the scale and I said, oh, you know, I really have to lose more weight. And he said, you know, really, when you're up there in years, we don't like our patients to be too skinny. As long as your weight is not affecting your health, it's okay to have a little extra weight on. So I bet that makes a lot of you feel good, doesn't it? I guess by now you've realized that this is not rocket science. This is getting rid of any negative energy around. That's so important. Being positive and challenging yourself. So if you're interested in becoming a super ager, then follow some of these habits. Remember the four habits. Basically, do some exercise, keep your body going, challenge your brain, study things that you're not familiar with, things that maybe you're interested in, and get into the internet. So many things you can do. Hobbies. We all know about eating, and I'm not going to get into that. We all know what we're supposed to eat. They say the Mediterranean DASH diet, they're the best. Your fruits, your veggies, your fish. Just do it and do it well. Let's talk about some men that are in that super ager group. Rupert Murdoch, some of these big businessmen. He and his buddies, the Koch brothers from New York City, they're all up into their 80s and 90s. Do you remember George Burns, the comedian? He lived to be 100. And one of his favorite jokes was, he was always talking about his age. And this is the one I remember. He said, "Whenever I would stoop down to tie my shoes, I'd always look around and think, what else can I do while I'm down here?" Now, number one, to be able to stoop down and tie your shoes at 100 was a pretty good feat to begin with. The one thing that all these people had, Ruth Bader Ginsburg, Grandma Moses, all these people that we've heard about, and one that I was impressed by, Michelangelo, I think he died when he was 87, and at the time he said, "I'm still learning." And the Japanese artist who carved beautiful wood waves and things, when he died in his high 80s, I think he might have been pushing 90, he said, "If only the heavens would give me another 5 years, I would paint the perfect painting in the world." Of course, I think he might have done that anyway, or carved it. I think he was a wood carver. So it's simple. Be a super ager if you choose, living the best life that you can live. Is an easy thing to do. You might have to get rid of some negativity in your life. You might have to get up out of your chair and be a little more active. But to be a super ager does not take much. It just takes attitude. So change your attitude. Let's all do it. Maybe some of you are there already, and good for you. I'm not heading for the beach to run in the waves today, but I think I'm going to do some more gardening and I'm going to do some more active walk. Get out there, do some volunteering, go the extra mile, and we'll be able to call you a super ager. So happy living, everyone. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this. It's a simple concept. Be positive. We can do it. And give me your comments and let me know how you're doing. God bless us all. Bye for now.